As you can see, I'm trying to build a shelter. I'm taking advantage of the hole in the ground. It's just a natural occurring hole in the ground, and I want to build around it. And then the plan is to fill it with sticks, branches, to make an A-frame shelter, and then eventually hopefully put moss on the outside of it. And if it all goes to plan, I'm going to come back here in a few days' time to spend 2 nights, maybe 3 nights, right here in the woodland with my dog, sleeping under the stars. It's really cold at the moment. It goes down to about -4 at night time. I'm gonna have to bring some deer skins, some sheep skins, something to just to lie on so I can put my sleeping bag on and keep the dog warm as well. Who knows, I might even bring the wood stove. So the moss I'm collecting is just moss that's been growing on some of these trees that have been cut down. And you can tell they've been cut down many, many years ago because they're just absolutely rotten. So this moss just forms a mat that goes around it. And by peeling it off, that is what I end up with. And by putting lots of these layers on top of the shelter, that's what's going to help me, well, keep me warm at night. Sometimes you can pick up big pieces of moss in one, whereas other times the forest floor is carpeted in moss and it's a matter of just taking a sheet, peeling it off the ground and then putting it onto the roof. The thing about the moss is it's not going to give me a watertight seal for if and when it rains, but it's going to keep me nice and warm when that wood stove or that small fire is going within the shelter. So that is it for this video. It's just an example of a stealth shelter you can build in the woodland using nothing but your hands. I've used no axes, knives or saws to build this. I've just used a pair of gloves in order to save my hands from getting too dirty. It's just an example of a stealth shelter. You know, I wouldn't rely on this for long-term survival or long-term living off-grid in the woods, because That roof there, it's good for a few days, but I wouldn't want to stay in it during a torrential downpour or a thunderstorm. The great thing about this moss is that it gives you a bit of insulation, so on a cold night you can have a small fire inside or even put a small wood stove inside. And because of the moss, it'll keep you nice and warm and keep the cold air out. So anyway, that is it. As I was just saying, it's the end of the video. Please let me know if you like this video by giving it a thumbs up. Let me know in the comments below what you want to see me do here next time. Mind you, I will bring a wood stove, my dog, an axe and knife and a saw, some food, a sleeping bag and some deer skins to sleep on. I'll see you then. Goodbye.